This workers' day in Brazil was like no other. Thousands traveled from across the country to the city of Curitiba in southern Brazil. They came in caravans of buses, riding overnight or even for several days. This was the first time that all seven of Brazil's major trade union federations have united for Workers' Day since the fall of the country's military dictatorship in 1985.
E esse 1º de maio é histórico porque ele une não só as centrais sindicais, mas une também as duas frentes, a Frente Brasil Popular e a Frente Povo Sem Medo, numa unidade da classe trabalhadora nunca vista antes do nosso país.
They are united behind one common goal, freeing Lula. For the last month, former President Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva has been serving time in this federal prison in Curitiba. In a controversial trial, judges convicted him of corruption for allegedly accepting a beachside apartment from a company seeking government contracts. He was sentenced to 12 years. But Lula and Brazilian workers say he's innocent. They believe his imprisonment is just a ruse to knock him out of the running for this year's presidential elections. Despite prison, Lula is still well ahead in the polls. Eliana Rocha traveled by bus from Rio de Janeiro with dozens of companions.
Contra esse arbítrio absurdo de ter o maior líder brasileiro, o maior político brasileiro vivo, inocente, preso por golpistas. O Brasil inteiro está vindo para cá para dizer que a prisão dele é injusta.
Since Lula's jailing, hundreds have participated in an around-the-clock vigil just down the street from where he's being held. With supporters from around the country, the crowd swelled on Workers' Day into the thousands. Workers have taken a beating under President Michel Temer, who rose to power after the impeachment of Lula's successor, Dilma Rousseff. Last year, Congress passed the new labor reform, gutting workers' rights and opening the door to sidestep unions. Lula, they hope, could turn the tide.
Mas nesse momento que a gente enxerga que o golpe que foi dado contra os trabalhadores não foi contra o presidente Dilma, sim contra os trabalhadores, foi um golpe muito duro e esse golpe unificou todos os trabalhadores e trabalhadoras no sentido de buscar a defesa do Lula e reverter todo esse quadro que está aí, que é um desastre para a classe trabalhadora.
Falar Lula livre, inocente, nosso presidente, é o maior instrumento de luta que os trabalhadores têm para ter os seus direitos de volta.
On stage, union leaders stood side by side. Lula's imprisonment has paradoxically united the country's left in a way that has not been seen in decades. Unions, social movements, leftist parties. At stake, they say, is nothing less than the fate of Brazilian democracy.
Esse 1º de maio é 1º de maio pelo direito dos trabalhadores, pela luta dos trabalhadores, mas é também 1º de maio pela luta democrática no nosso país. Uma democracia que está sendo ferida a cada dia.
Under the Temer government, the country has also seen a dramatic rise of the right, hate groups, and violence. The pro-Lula camp in Curitiba was attacked by a gunman less than a week ago. Two people were injured, one of them hospitalized. The bullets were found to come from police stocks, just like those used in the assassination of Marielle Franco, the black LGBT councilwoman from Rio, whose killing sparked international outrage in March. The calls for justice for both Marielle and Lula rang out from the stage.
Eles mataram Marielle e prenderam Lula, mas nós estamos aqui para dizer que Marielle vive, vive nós, viva Marielle, Lula livre, viva a democracia. Vamos à luta, companheiros.
The months leading up to the October election will likely define Brazil for the coming years. If Lula is allowed to run, it will only be because of the unity and organizing happening today in Curitiba and across the country.